You'll never outbid me.
Well, I love a challenge.
Well, you know what? My paper's selling like hotcakes. I'm making a bloody fortune.
Listen, why would you even want to buy this place? You haven't even
seen
it.
Well, you know what? If it's good enough for you, it's good enough for me to steal out from under you. So I'm off to see Mr. Banker. I intend to pay in cash.
Huh? Yeah, I think I told her. I'm going home. What am I doing? I'll get friends. I'll show her. Yeah. I got the message machine. Go. Hey, Molly, it's Jake. Listen, I just looking at this condo I'm thinking about buying and just wanted to see if you want to come by and, you know, maybe get a chick's opinion. Anyway, I'll talk to you later. All righty. Hey, Molly, listen, about the message that I left you earlier. It's kind of not accurate. I decided to buy the condo already. I just wanted to know if you wanted to have... Maybe thinking about how... See if you want to have dinner, okay? Okay. Bye.
I get no kick from champagne.
Actually, Lisa and I got to know each other when Tom and I were engaged.
Wait, you and Tom were?
We were, and she dumped me at the altar for James Stenbeck. So what were you thinking?
And the two of them used to meet for sodas in this little store called the Sweet Shop. And Bob said he thought Lisa was the prettiest girl he'd ever seen.
Yeah, well, it looks like he knew what he was talking about.
And then Lisa came to me for some help. I was furious when she told me they'd sneaked off and gotten married. And I told her that we were going to have the marriage annulled because they were both underage. And then she told me she was pregnant.
Oh.
I did an about face and took her in my arms and my house and my heart. And she and I have been battling each other and loving each other ever since.
Isn't this fun?
Yeah, I think she's going to be thrilled.
Oh, you can bet on it. I love it.
Boo.
Hey. Didn't have to come?
Well, I have my own personal reasons to want to see Emily Stewart. Not.
In that case, you are in the perfect place.
Ooh, I feel it.
Oh, okay. All right, everybody, she's here.
Here. Right,
I'm up here.
Everybody.
I get no kick in a plane. Flying too high.
What's going on? I mean, what? Where is everybody?
Cooked up for tonight, you know. You see, Julie and I plan on sicking our detectives on Emily.
Oh, no, don't bother. Emily will mess herself up. She always does.
Oh, here to that.
Speech!
Uh-oh.
Speech! Come on!
Your adoring public awaits. Come on.
Isaac, thank you, honey. Thank you so much.
Well, everybody, thank you so much for being here today, and also, I thank you so much for accepting me and understanding me. And I do hope with all my heart that you forgive me. You're just such... I can't think what I'm going to say. I know it's important, but It's a favor I have to ask. I want you to please just tell me that you love me. That's all I want to hear. I want to hear that you love me, and it wouldn't hurt if you gushed a lot. Now that, I mean, all the sentimental thoughts that you have that you were going to say over my grave. Oh, no, I want you to say it now so I can enjoy it. Believe me, I'd rather have this whole room full of people than, well, a newspaper circulation that went all over the world. I think that would be far better. So, Emily Stewart, wherever you are, eat your heart out, Cookie.
Lisa, here's to you. You are the bane and blessings to so many of our lives here. You've also been a headache at times. But you have never, never been a bore.
Cheers.
Now, may I have this done?
Yes, you may.
Here we are, after all these years, face to face, heart to heart, and I've loved you from the start. But I never thought that we'd be standing here after all these years. Here we are with another song to sing. All these days pass us by as we watched our childhood fly, and I'm still the one to share your hopes and fears after all.